गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स. सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 3, अंडरस्टैंडिंग क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स. सो इन दिस चैप्टर फर्स्ट वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड सम इम्पॉर्टेंट टर्म्स. दोज आर सिंपल कर्व, सिंपल क्लोज्ड कर्व, पॉलीगॉन्स, कॉनकेव पॉलीगॉन्स एंड कॉन्वेक्स पॉलीगॉन्स. सो आफ्टर दैट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द एक्सरसाइज. So first one, see here, simple curve. Simple, what is the meaning of simple curve? Simple curve means it does not intersect itself. See this figure I am going to draw here. This figure intersected here. This figure intersect. So it is not a simple curve. So simple curve means what? It does not intersect itself. So when you start one figure, let me draw here. So here I draw like this. Okay. Next. See. So this is a simple curve, students. So this is a simple curve. Here they not intersected. A single line. Again, it not intersect here. So it means both these figures, they are the simple curve. See here, this is the first one and this is the second one. So both these are a simple curve. Simple curve means it does not intersect itself. Okay, so here it intersect the single line, it intersect each other. So therefore it is not a simple curve. Next, see the second one. Simple closed curve. Here the figures, they are closed, they are not open. So here it is open. It is open, but it is a simple curve. But here, all the figures, they are closed. See, in this, so first we are going to learn what is this definition. Simple closed curve means it ends where it starts. It ends where it starts. See here, as I told before, I started figure here. All of you students here. Okay. I started here. From this point, I started, na students. So next I continued here like this. Okay, where it ends where it starts. So it ends here. So this is the closed curve. Okay, next, polygons. A simple closed curve made up of only line segments. Here the figure, it is only made up of line segments. So all these are the polygons. And what are the types of polygons? Triangle, quadrilateral, pentagon, hexagon, heptagon, anagon, decagon. So all these are the types of polygons. So here all the figures, they made up of line segments. Okay, so here both these examples, they are the polygons. Okay students. So next, concave polygons. In concave polygon, at least one angle is more than 180 degree, then it is a concave polygon. See students here, this angle, this angle, this angle, so all these are less than 180 degree, but this angle, students, it is more than 180 degree. So it means in concave polygons, what happens? One angle, it is only one angle, let keep in mind, only one angle, it is a more than 180 degree. So these are concave polygons. Next, convex polygon. All of you see here. So in the convex polygons, what happens? All the angles, they are less than 180 degree. See in this figure, this angle, this angle, this angle, all these angles, they are less than 180 degree. So less than 180 degree means like this, they comes here. Okay. So more than 180 means the angles comes like this. Okay, so this is more than 180 and this is a less than 180. So in this convex polygons, what happens? All the angles, they are less than 180 degree, students. So these are basic knowledge about the convex polygons, polygons, concave polygons, okay, simple curve and closed curve. Okay, so now let me start the exercise here. See the exercise 3.1, students, all of you here. What is the first question? Given here are some figures. Okay, so in these figures we have to classify simple curve, simple closed curve, polygon, convex polygon and concave polygons. Okay students, so see the first one here. So this is first one, simple curve. Okay, simple curve means what? Simple curve means what, students? As I told you, simple curve means it does not intersect itself. Okay, so it means here first one it is okay. First figure it is a simple curve. Second one also it is a simple curve. Third it is not a simple curve because it contains two figures inside it. Okay, so it is not a simple curve. And fourth one also it is not a simple curve because here they intersected each other. Okay. Fifth one it is a simple curve. Okay, sixth one and seventh one. Okay, so both these are also they are the simple curve because they are not intersected here. But this eighth one it is not a simple curve because it contains one figure extra and one figure extra and one line here. So it is not a simple curve, friends. So this is regarding the simple curve. Next, simple closed curve. See, this is closed curve means it ends where it starts. Okay, so this first one, second one, okay, third one it not comes. Okay, because it contains two figures. Okay, next fourth one it is not possible. Fifth one, okay, because it where it starts it ends where it starts. Okay, and sixth one and again seventh one. So it's eighth one it is not a closed curve because it contains three figures here. Okay, two figures it contains extra here. This one and this one. Next, polygon. So polygon means what? A figure which is made up of only line segments here. So in this, only the first and second, only both these figures they made up of only by line segments. So therefore, polygons they are one and two only. So this one first figure and second figure only, both these are polygons. And next, convex. Convex polygons mean what, students? In convex polygons, all the angles are. In convex polygons, all the angles they are less than 180 degree. So in this figure, which figure you show, you find all the angles they are less than 180. So the second, in the second, all the angles they are less than 180 degree. So regarding in third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, there is no possible. Regarding less than 180, so only in the second. But in the first question, this angle it is more than 180 degree, so it is not a convex. Okay, so here we have only the answer as a second one. Okay, and regarding concave polygon, only the first figure it contains. In this figure, only one angle it is more than 180 degree. So it means first figure it is a concave polygon, students. Okay, so this is the solution for the first question. See the second question, friends, all of you here. How many diagonals does each of the following have? First one, a convex quadrilateral. So it is a example of convex quadrilateral. So this convex quadrilateral contains how many diagonals? See, this is the first one and this is the second. So it contains how many diagonals here? Two. Okay, and next, B, a regular hexagon. So this regular hexagon contains how many lines, how many diagonals here? So this is the first, okay, second, third, fourth, fifth, okay, fifth, this is the sixth, seventh, okay, this is the eighth, and this is the ninth. So how many diagonals this regular hexagon contains? 9. So regarding our triangle, it is not possible for us to draw any diagonals here because there is no end point to join here, students. Okay, so therefore the triangle it does not contains any diagonal. So it means here we have to write answer as a 0 here. Okay, so this is the solution for the second question. See the third problem, friends, all of you here. What is the sum of the measures of the angles of a convex quadrilateral? See, what is the sum of the measures of the angles of a convex quadrilateral? Will this property hold if the quadrilateral is not convex? Okay, here they give one hint, that is make a non-convex quadrilateral and try. So how to solve this one, friends? All of you see here. See, First here I drawn one convex quadrilateral. Convex quadrilateral means what? Here all the angles they are less than 180 degree here. See here, in this ABCD quadrilateral, let ABCD be a convex quadrilateral. Okay, quadrilateral ABCD is formed by two triangles. See, in this quadrilateral, it is made up of two triangles. That is ABC and ADC. Okay, so this quadrilateral, it is made up of two triangles. Okay, next. Next, what happens here? We know that the sum of interior angles of a triangle is how much? It is a 180 degree. So all of you know that the sum of all the angles of a triangle is how much? It is a 180. So it is a 180 degree, and this is a 180 degree. So total how much it becomes, friends? It becomes how much? 360 degree. Na here. So let me write that one here. The sum of the measures of the angles. Angles is how much? It is 180 plus 180. It becomes how much? 360 degree. Okay. So this is regarding the first what they given. So what next? What I am going to do here? I am going to make a little bit modification here. What I am going to make this figure as a concave quadrilateral. So how all of you see here? See this ABCD. See this ABCD convex quadrilateral, I am going to draw as a concave quadrilateral like this. ABCD, it is a concave quadrilateral. Okay. So next, see what happens here. Let us take another quadrilateral ABCD, which is not a convex. It is not a convex, it is a concave. Join BC. Here I draw join BC here. I joined BC. Next, such that it divides ABCD into two triangles. That is ABC and BCD. Here I drawn one line, the BC line, in a such way that it divides this ABCD concave quadrilateral two triangles, that is ABC and BCD. Okay, next see what happens, friends, here. In triangle ABC, see students here, in triangle ABC, see, in triangle ABC, okay, angle 1, angle 2, angle 3. So including if we add all these triangles, we get how much sum here? 180 degree, because angle sum property, my students here. So in this angle ABC, angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, so how much it becomes? 180 degree, because angle sum property. Similarly, in triangle BCD, in triangle BCD, angle 4, angle 5, angle 6, here angle 4 plus angle 5 plus 6, 180 degree, because angle sum property. So after adding both these, after adding this one and this one, how much we get here? Angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, and angle 4, angle 5, angle 6 is equal to 180 plus 180 degree. So how much comes? It is 360 degree. So it means ABCD, this ABCD, so after this means the, so including all these angles means what it is? It is nothing but angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D. So how much it comes? 360 degree here. So it means when we convert a convex into a concave, there is no changes happens here. Here also the sum comes how much? 360 degree. And in the previous, how much comes sum there? There also we see the sum as is 360 here, see. Here also we have 360 when the figure it is a convex, and when we make a little when we make this figure as a concave, the sum also here comes same here, students. Okay, thus this property hold the quadrilateral is not a convex. So this is the solution for the third problem, students. So I hope all of you understood all these problems. So let me stop here. Tomorrow I am going to solve the next problem, students. Thank you. Have a nice day.